Hello guys and welcome to a new video, and in today's video I'll be going through some interesting changes and additions they made to the game in the new test server. If you're looking for MP leaks, then you will find many videos already posted by other YouTubers, just search for them. Another two things to keep in mind before we start: that these changes are not confirmed, meaning that they might not be added, or maybe they will add them but differently. And the second thing, some additions may come next season and others might be delayed for two seasons from now. With that being said, let's get started. The first addition that I really loved, and many of you guys would love, is the new mode Solid Gold. Original old school battle royale, no classes, no revives. However, when I tried the mode, the class was available for me to use, but I assume that's a glitch. And when the mode actually comes out, it shouldn't be available. So notice that everything is almost the same. We got the entire map and 100 players total. But the biggest difference is that all the ground loot guns are golden, and all the mods are also golden. So apparently you can get knocked and your teammates can revive you, but if they don't, then you're dead for good. There is no dog tags and no coming back. The second thing that I'm not sure about is whether this mode gonna be ranked or just normal mode for fun. Moving on to the other changes, starting with the settings. They added new buttons and new options to the game, and few of them are extremely helpful. I'll start with the important ones. First of all, they added field of view range option for third person. This was only available for first person, but now you can enjoy a wide view of the battlefield, and with this you can spot enemies much easier. The only thing that might be weird when you increase the field of view is the hipfire, because the aiming will be a little bit different. Next, we have what I believe the most needed addition in the settings, which is the auto expand wingsuit option. As you know, the current version opens the wingsuit automatically when you jump, as long as you have the height needed. But if you disable this option, then you'll be able to manually open your wingsuit using this button right here, and it shows up right after you jump from heights. So my advice is to disable this option at all times, and I'll tell you why. First of all, in situations like this, when there's an enemy under you and you're trying to rush him, if you have auto wingsuit option enabled, then it will open the wingsuit, which will alert the enemy. And it also delays your attack, and overall it will mess you up and puts you in a disadvantage. But if you disable it, then you'll be able to just fall normally and surprise your enemy, giving them no chance to react. The second reason and why you want it disabled is when jumping from lower heights. See, in this example, I'll jump from the same spot, once with the option enabled and the other without it. Let's start with the auto expand enabled, and you can see that it failed to open the wingsuit. And if I disable the option, I'm able to glide from the same spot and the same height using the wingsuit button. So yeah, once this option is out, make sure it's disabled. Moving on to the other smaller changes. From the top, we have continuous grenade throw. If you have this option on, you'll be able to throw your throwables non-stop, just like that. And if you turn it off, then you can only throw one at a time. As you can see, once I threw one, my character switches back to the gun, and I have to press the throwable button again to throw more of them. Next, we have the ADS button for rotation. And what it does is, when you use the ADS button, you can press and hold it, then use it to rotate and aim at your targets. But if you turn it off, then you won't be able to do that, and you have to press somewhere else on the screen to rotate and aim. Then we have fast scope switch. Although it's a great addition to the game, I don't think many players will use it. But I think it's good to have. So what it does is, when you have a gun that uses more than one scope, then you can use this new button here to quickly switch between the scopes without having to open your bag and doing it manually. Then we have slide hit. It's not important, but I'll explain it anyway. When you enable this option, then the crouch button turns to slide button when you slide, just to show that you're sliding. That's it. If you have it off, then it will always show crouch button. After that, we have gun special effects option, and for most of you guys, you don't have to worry about that, because I know most of you are broke anyway. So you can disable the effects of your legendary guns, like the body effects, the death effects, and the muzzle flash effects. Finally, we have a new option which is again very useful. That's the sound reminder, and it's available for minimap and the main screen. So for the minimap, they explained it well here. If you choose direction, then it will only show a general direction of the gunshots or the step sounds. And if you choose sound location, it will show the exact location of the gunshot on the minimap. As for the main HUD sound reminder, it shows the steps and the gunshot indicators right on your screen. And if you feel like they're distracting you, then you can disable them from here. Other than that, they added new option to the graphics, which is God rays, and it's basically these rays coming from the sun. It just adds more beauty and realism to the game. Moving on to the game itself, first of all, they changed the look of the plane and it looks more badass now. After landing, you'll notice a slight change in the graphics and the overall theme is more like a sunset. I don't want to get you guys excited, but they fixed the camera glitch. Now you can go inside buildings without having to worry about your camera going crazy. But you know, it was also fixed in the test server of the last season, but when the actual season came out, sadly the glitch was still there. But let's hope it's actually fixed in both test and official release this time. There is a big change that will affect many players, which is the snowboard speed. They made it slower now. I mean, the speed is the same at snowy areas, but outside snow I noticed that it's much slower than usual. And personally, I don't like this change and I think it was perfect as it is. Just to make sure I'm right, I gave it a test. So we'll see how long it takes to cover the same distance in both versions. So even with the late start, Siren was faster by 5 seconds. Other additions include a new building in Sakura, new reticles for ground loot guns, which I think is pretty cool, vehicles music when everyone is camping and you get bored, you can just turn it on and enjoy some music. Another cool thing they added is an easy way to mark loot for teammates. Now you can just press this button right here and it will mark it right away. I just wish they would add an option to disable this because I feel like many players will end up pressing it by mistake, which can be a bit annoying. Also, medic and loot boxes now have new visuals and sound effects. They also removed a lot of the mountains across the map, like the one near farm and the one near the kill house, and also the mountains near countdown and practice range. I'm not sure why exactly and I'm not an expert, but maybe they did it to reduce the game size. Then they added ramps to the snow tracks. Now you can have fun when being chased by thirsty squads. At least you can die in style. I also had the chance to try the new Rewind class, which is an interesting class. So what it does, it teleports you 5 seconds into the past, and the passive reduces the duration of the flash coming from flashbangs and concussion grenades. I'm not gonna go into details about this class because it's coming out soon this month, so I'll do a separate video on it explaining everything in details. As for the nerfs, other than the snowboard nerf, they also nerfed the ninja class. Now without an upgrade, it only has one hook instead of two. And after upgrading it, you get two instead of three. And honestly, nobody asked for this and nobody complained about the ninja. Not to mention that they already nerfed it 2 seasons ago by reducing the range. And on top of that, this class doesn't work 90% of the time anyway. If it was working like the first 4 seasons, then maybe these changes would have been acceptable. But it's not the case, and I hope Activision reconsiders this nerf, and I promise you, not because I'm a ninja man, but it just doesn't feel right. They will end up killing one of the most fun classes in the game with these unnecessary nerfs. We also have a new vehicle, which is a sports car. And let me tell you, this car is amazing. Not only because it looks good, but it's also fast and stable on the road. It doesn't lose balance or flip in rough terrains, and it also has a special feature where you can drive in first person perspective. And that's a feature that's limited to this car only. Another small change is the ability to display vehicles in the lobby background. And we arrived to the final change that I want to talk about, which is the ground loot guns change. They made some very interesting changes, starting with the purple AK-47. Like, the white AK-47 was already broken. Can't imagine how a purple one gonna be. The other toxic addition is the purple echo. So basically, if you get a purple AK-47 and a purple echo, then you don't need loadout guns anymore. Then we have the blue HS-04 shotgun, and I think this one's gonna be fun and annoying at the same time. Fun in your hands, but annoying in the enemy hands. We also have some good changes that I like to see. The blue blue M4 and the purple AK-117. Both these versions can add some more variety to the game, especially the M4. And finally, we have the purple Phoenix. So overall, they made it more possible to win the game without having to loot an airdrop, which is a good thing in my opinion. That was everything for now. I'm still testing and looking for more changes, and if I find any, then I'll share them with you guys. I really hope you found this useful, and remember, nothing is confirmed. It's a test version after all. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.